Yeah, so thanks everyone for joining this session. This is a great honor to present our hackathon entry we participated for the SharePoint Hackathon that was greatly encouraged by Vesa. I can tell that he promoted this hackathon quite a lot, and it was a great experience for us to participate and to explore the solutions into the different categories that we saw, and there were some great submissions that we saw in the hackathon as well. So out of the different sections that was categories that was provided to us, so we started looking into the category of the SharePoint agents, because currently in Capgemini we are focusing a lot of things not only from the SharePoint perspective but also like the Copilot perspective, and SharePoint agent is something quite new in which we are investing quite a lot, and we started to understand that how SharePoint agents can be created quite easily, how things can be made much more easier from the purpose of the client. So that's how we wanted to explore in the hackathon itself, right? So this hackathon was participated by 4 team members from our organization. So Kuntal, Pritham, Sneashish, they are from India. They participated along with me. Because of our combined experience of SharePoint and Power Platform, so we thought that we will be bringing some of the Power Platform concepts as well. So that I will show in the demo as well. So I won't spend too much time on this, and we'll go directly into what we created and from the SharePoint agents perspective and why we took that case study. So one of the things that we encountered like day to day while working with like organization, like financial organizations, primarily like insurance or banking, for in this case it's much more from the insurance perspective, that there's a lot of activities that is done even now, those are kind of like manual, and lot of documents are involved. So you can understand that it's not only about creating the policies but also the claims, then the risk assessment. So there are a lot of documentation that goes through the process of the underwriting as well as from the operations perspective. So we wanted to explore that, how easily that SharePoint agent created within the SharePoint site itself can actually minimize all these manual activities. And we started creating the SharePoint agent, but then we understood that it would be much more it would make much more sense in a way if we actually target the SharePoint agents. Targeting in the sense that we will always have different sets of business users, right, who will be working in a SharePoint site in the organization, and they will be interested only a specific set of data. So if that is a segregation that we are looking, in which people will be interested only on a specific set of the data and their working, then the agent should also be very specific rather than bringing information from different places. So for that reason, we created like 2 agents in the SharePoint. One is called the Policy Guru and one is called Claims Buddy. So Policy Guru was primarily designed to equip the operations team who will be working closely with the underwriters, who will be helping in automating or providing the information that will be required for creating some policies for the customers. Whereas a claims buddy is an agent which will actually work together along with the claims team, in which it can look into the claims that has been submitted by the customers. It can do certain checks as well with the standard wordings that we are having, that whether the claims are correct or not, and then it can give certain decisions on the documents that has been received. And definitely, if you are looking into these kind of automations, we would see that there will be a reduction of the human effort. And what we understood from talking with the businesses as well, that we can easily reduce at least 15% to 20% of their manual activities in a day, which is quite a lot if you think from that perspective. And since these agents can be also used in Teams perspective, so we can actually share these agents in Teams. So logically, you can actually use the Teams channel, Teams chat, in which you will be able to do a conversation with this agent, just like the conversation you are doing with like any agents that you are having in the Teams. So that's a very powerful capability in which we are surfacing the information of the SharePoint, and we are actually collaborating as well, right? So I will move into our demo. So let me go back. Okay, so this is the SharePoint site. So this is a very standard team site which we created for our SharePoint Hackathon. This is having certain capabilities in which you will be able to create a policy request, a claims request, and there are certain details that you can access from the resources perspective. One of the challenges that we faced, and that I will come shortly, that SharePoint agents, as of now, it cannot read directly from the SharePoint lists, right? So let's say that if someone is raising a policy request or a claims request, we are using SharePoint list to capture those information, but then how those information will be used across from the perspective of a SharePoint agent. For that, what we did, we took help of Power Automate workflows, and from Power Automate workflows, we captured the information from the SharePoint list, and we created our documents out of it, because those documents can be fed as a knowledge repository to the SharePoint agents that we have created. That's how we went through from the solution perspective, and then we realized as well that going forward, that if the documents can be created from a SharePoint list, then it can also be used to create documents, let's say, from the Dataverse table. So the basically, there are different things that we can do going forward, just not restricted within the SharePoint environment, right? One of the things that I mentioned, that information is very much important from the perspective of the SharePoint agents, because there's a declarative agent that we are creating. So information architecture is something that we care very seriously in this perspective, because we wanted to make sure that we are capturing this information in a correct way, right? So one of the things that I wanted to showcase, that we are creating a library called, let's say, client documents. It's a it's having these document sets. So these document sets are basically a document set of a client, and then these document sets are having different subfolders, which are having the claims documents or the identity documents or the policy documents that got generated, right? So all these informations are segregated in a way, and along with that, if we go into the site contents, we would see that there are libraries that has been created, which provides like claims processing guidance. So basically, there are documents that has been created in which it can provide like how to process a claim that is related to, let's say, car insurance or something regarding travel insurance, a claim that has been raised by a client. So we have created certain libraries like this, and I will show you like why we have done this going forward. So let me open the agent. So let's say that I want to just edit this agent. So claims body is the first agent that I wanted to show you. So if you see that we are describing the purpose of the agent, that it's going to, like I said, that it's going to assess the claims team for the processing of the claims. It will review the claims. So we are giving a lot of instructions from the description's perspective, like what it's supposed to do. And from the sources perspective, we see that there are certain sources that we have targeted. So this agent that we have created for the claims purposes, for the claims team, is looking into only specific libraries that is relevant for them. It's not going to look into the libraries that is much more required for the operations perspective, let's say. So that's how we grounded the information. So grounding is very important from the purpose of how we are going to get the maximum benefit out of these agents, right? And like I said, the behavior and everything that we wanted to, that claims buddy should be doing. So we have described all this quite vividly in this behavior section so that we know like what are the things claims body can do. And we have given certain starter prompts as well, like comparing the claims, unvalidated the claim in details, getting some guidance, which are the common things that we know that claims team will be doing. And similarly, we have done for the policy guru as well, if we see. And again, if you notice that it is looking into certain other document libraries, which the claims body is not looking. And again, that is how the segregation is happening, right? And because these are the agents that has been created in the SharePoint site level, so you can access this wherever you want from the SharePoint site. And like I said, that one of the most powerful thing that I noticed is about copying this link into the Teams. And basically, we can just share this agent in the Teams chat, and we can have the conversation there, right? So let's take an example that we wanted to discuss with Policy Guru something about client that we are having. So let's pick up some of the clients that we are having right now. So we'll pick up someone. Okay. So it's looking into the site, and it's giving me all the information. And I can also ask about certain things about, let's say, that what is that policy is all about. So I want to understand, like, what is this policy all about? So so it is just giving me all the information that is required regarding the policies that has been issued to David that I can see, and also the claims processes that is relevant for the policy that has been issued. And it can also be used for doing some kind of risk assessment. So if I want, I can look into the profile of David to understand whether he is an eligible person for getting, let's say, a travel insurance. If you see, it is looking into, it's trying to look into the whatever information that we're having. And it is trying to determine that depending on the age, depending on the purpose of the travel, the location, et cetera, whether travel insurance is applicable for David, right? So similarly, if we can switch into the claims buddy, and we can compare the claims, or we can discuss about some of the claims that is already present. Can you validate the claim? Submitted with ID. Let's take one of the claims, CLM. Okay, so it is able to give me all the details about the claim and also the associated policies that is associated with this claim. So we know from this claim that what kind of policy it is. And if we go into the details of the policies, we would know about the policy wordings as well. So using the claims body, we would be able to just determine very quickly that whether the claims is a valid claim or not, whether this policy is capturing the exclusions and the inclusions as well. That has been raised from the claims perspective and can help the claims team to achieve the results much more faster than they would have done if they are looking into the each of the documents manually day in, day out, right? So so that's how we wanted to showcase the power of the SharePoint agents, declarative agents in the hackathon's purposes. Like I said, that they are very powerful, even though they are declarative. And if we are able to do some kind of modifications using the Power Platform, let's say some of the capabilities that we just demonstrated, that SharePoint list can be converted into a document which can be fed into the knowledge repository, I think the SharePoint agents can go a long way going forward, right? Yeah, so I think that is from my end, Faisa.